All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is one session I truly want to see from the bottom of my heart. He's not only the CEO and Managing Director of Hindustan Unilever Limited, he also leads Unilever's business in South Asia as the Executive Vice President and is currently the Vice President of Bombay Chamber of Commerce and Industry and member of National Committees of CII and FICCI. Ladies and gentlemen, he's also our 2018 Indian Digital Marketing Awards Grand Jury Chair, and he will be talking about the changing role of marketing in achieving business objectives. Ladies and gentlemen, I, Siddharth Kannan, personally look up to him so much. Please, a warmest round of applause for Mr. Sanjiv Mehta.
To suck? Okay. A few minutes. We've got a few minutes, guys. Anyone wants to sing a song, you're welcome.
Yeah, if you want to, I can come to you. We can sing a lovely song. And you want me to? All right, why not, man? But I need an audience for that. All right. Anybody who's outside the ballroom, I'd request you to please come inside. You hear that ghanti bajoing? That ghanti is to tell you that coffee won't be served outside. Snacks won't be served outside. Nothing is going to be served outside because Mr. Sanjiv Mehta is about to begin in the next 2 minutes from now. In the meanwhile, ladies and gentlemen, please come inside. Take your seats. Kyunki bahar kuch nahi milega. Jo milega, andar hi milega. You're taking my voice outside. You're like my crusader. Can I have the doors open, please, sir? Khol dijiye. Thodi awaaz bahar pahunche to aur maza aa jaye yaar. Kyun nahi? Right? All right. If you can hear me outside the ballroom, we are about to begin. Everything outside is shut. 2 minutes to go for Mr. Sanjiv Mehta to be talking about the changing role of marketing. No tea coffee outside. What happens is only inside.
Okay.
Okay, Mr. Mehta, before people come in, I've got someone who wants to sing a song. It'll take us a minute more. Come on, let's do this.
Wonderful.
Mr. Mehta.
Let's give her a big round of applause.
Open the doors, please. And can I request my lovely volunteers who are here, just open the door. We'll get people inside because this is a session I really want to do. Honestly, since the morning, I've been waiting for this session. So, Mr. Mehta, what's your name, lady?
Stuti Anand Singh.
Stuti, we'd like to dedicate it to Mr. Mehta. You love music, you love singers, you love great talent and everyone here as well. So, here goes.
Come on!
Okay, so this is a song by Adele, Set Fire to the Rain. I let it fall. My heart, and as it fell, you rose to claim it. It was dark, and I was over, until you kissed my lips, and you failed me. My hands, they were strong, but my knees were far too weak to stand in your arms. Will I fall into your feet? But there's a side to you that I never knew all the things you say they were never true in the games you play. You would always been, but I set fire to the rain and it fell. Na 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 na. Something died, cause I knew that that was the last time I set fire to the rain. Na 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 na. And it felt something died, cause I knew that there was the last time. Thank you so much.
Lovely. Let's give her a big round of applause. Thank
I'm
you.
I'm a fan of her, sir.
I know.
You
all
know,
of us are.
Adele just got very insecure, like I got insecure of Samir, like that. So, Mr. Mehta, lights.
All right.
Camera, action.
Hi, good evening, everyone. So, I have about 15, 20 minutes. I want to share some of my thoughts with you in the whole space of marketing. More importantly, marketing in the connected world. You know, I feel very amused when people talk about digital marketing. Yeah, digital and marketing, it's not that digital is going to influence only marketing. The entire connected world will be significantly influenced by the fourth industrial revolution. So it's very important for us to take cognizance that marketing has one of the key functions, and it's going to be certainly be impacted, but all industries and the entire value chain would be impacted in a significant way as we go forward. Now, a decade ago, not many years back, just a decade ago, no one owned a smartphone. Twitter was an English word. We didn't know the Facebook, and we shopped exclusively in real shops. Yeah, that was the kind of context in which all of us grew up learning marketing. Now, that world has changed significantly and dramatically, but we certainly believe that the change that we have seen in the past, it will really be put to shame by change which is going to come in the future. Now, the important trends that are shaping India is, of course, mobile in a very big way. The other important bit is urbanization and the empowerment of the rural consumers. In India, unlike China, urbanization has yet to take place. We are still talking about 67% of our countrymen living in rural areas, but these consumers would be empowered like we have never seen before. The other is the power of vernacular content. When Google started its vernacular services, the search spiked up by 60% in the very first week. That's the kind of power of vernacular. And of course, the other is how voice is going to change the world and the role that influencers play in making consumers pick up the choice. Now, the future of industry is already here. But the key aspect is that what technology exists today will get reshaped tomorrow. And what was best in class or a next-gen practice last year has already become outdated today. That's the shape of the change that is taking place across our world. Now, for decades, I come from a fast-moving consumer goods background. And in FMCG, over the years, the business model was built around scale. Scale in manufacturing, scale in distribution, scale in advertising, you have the scale, you get better purchasing power. Branding was, of course, key to the consumer choice. Then we had a massive distribution setup, and then you leverage cloud to drive down your costs. Now, if we look at the classical business model that we had, you would go and do consumer research in a very traditional way, knock on the doors, try to find out the unmet needs, come back, make prototypes, get them tested again through a classical market research. Then you would give it for factory trials. Then you would, once having manufactured it, then you would have the massive distribution machinery. Then we would have the classical 30-second TVCs. Then you would spray and pray that hope you hit the audience. And that is how the value got created. If we look at it today, technology is going to reshape every aspect of it. The classical market research, that is becoming passe. Today, in our people data center, we monitor conversations happening across the world on all our brands 24/7. So we know the trends that are shaping. Yeah, today in our PRM, we have consumers call us 10,000 times a day. And they don't talk about
कि यार आपने ये ट्रेस्मे की प्रमोशन की है ये मेरी दुकान में नहीं मिल रहा है. दे टॉक मोर अबाउट दैट आई हैव अ वेडिंग इन द फैमिली व्हाट काइंड ऑफ हेयरडू शुड आई हैव. Yeah, my I'm going out with my friends. What is the kind of makeup I need to have? This is the kind of skin I have. So what kind of cream I need to use? So they are conversing with us. When you have a PRM based like we do and the PDC that we have, and then you are able to convert voice into text, you don't need a classical market research to find out trends. When we develop prototypes today, we don't need to do real prototypes because we do all the simulation on computers. Even the trial runs on the plants that we used to do earlier, we simulate it on computers today. There was a time when market mix modeling of seeing which of the levers you need to play in the market would take you months to come out with the results. Today we have got Bayesian network where it is done on an iterative basis. And you play around going beyond regression and looking at different levers and the simultaneous play in the market. Now think of a context in our business where we have thousands of SKUs, where we reach millions of outlets. But in any given outlet, you will find 150 to 200 SKUs of Hindustan Unilever. The critical aspect is in an outlet, out of the thousands of SKUs, which of those 150, 200 SKUs are the most relevant for that outlet? Today, technology allows you to customize your offering to each outlet. A grocery on Pedder Road will have a completely different assortment based compared to, say, a grocery in Thaisar. That's what, again, technology allows you to do. So the entire business model of FMCG is up for grabs. And whoever can reinvent it will be able to get a lion's share of the profit that would come out of the new business model. Consumer journeys. Oh, that was a very simple life. Yeah, you watch the ad, either on the print or on the hoarding or on the commercial. Yeah, you talk to a few of your friends, go to the store, pick up your brand and you are home. Today, consumer journeys have become extremely complicated. And that is where you need to get a deeper understanding of what you need to do, where you need to do, how you intervene in the consumer journey to make a difference to your brands and to convert the consumers from intent to purchase. The three ABCs that are reshaping marketing and changing the way are, of course, machine learning and artificial intelligence, the big data and analytics, and of course, in a very big way, it is the content. Now, underpinning all this is data. In Hindustan Unilever, I've got a chief data officer who now sits on my top table. And that is for the simple reason, we have massive amount of data, both online and offline data. And it is all about storing data. It is all about ensuring the safety of data. It is all about using data in the most meaningful way. It is no longer about the raw data, but increasingly it is becoming intelligent data that you put forth to use. Now we have got profiles of nearly 150 million consumers. And based on 150 million consumers, you can easily group them into cohorts and mimic the entire population in a very big way. That's where the challenge exists as to where in their shopper journey can you intervene with the right kind of content. So data becomes the most important ingredient in this entire digital landscape. And that is the reason people talk about data being the new oil. In Hindustan Unilever, we have a framework called the 5C framework. At the heart of this 5C framework, the consumers will always be there. Yeah? Irrespective of whether you're online or offline, whether it is a connected world or an offline world, at the end of the day, you are looking at the needs, wants, and desires of a consumer and doing your best to meet them. That's what a job is. That's how we create value for the consumer, and that's how we create value for ourselves. The other big four C's are, of course, content, connect, Yeah, that's so important in the new world. And when we look at from the lens of connect, it is not just connecting it in the traditional way that we are talking about, but also things like geotagging. That's when you are able to influence the consumers in a very big way. The other is the community. Community becomes so important, especially when you talk about purposeful brands. It's only when, and you know, the classical stories about marketing are when they can be co-created together with your consumers. That is when it really becomes a very telling effect and makes a huge impact on the business. The other, of course, is the commerce. Commerce is something which I would believe you would have been discussing throughout the day. In India, still commerce is a very small part of the total FMCG landscape, though galloping at a very fast pace. Even globally, it is about 6-7%. It may be 6-7%, but the impact of the 5 C's goes beyond the online to the offline as well. Consumers are our true north. That's what we talk about. From triggers, influences to actions. And the important bit is that in your quest towards technology, if you lose the sense of consumers, then you miss the game altogether. Yeah? What technology allows us to do is, rather than treating and going in a classical mass marketing way, it allows you to do precision marketing, or it allows you to do massive customization. That's what technology allows you to do. The other is content that consumers love. As Hindustan Unilever, we want to be the Wikipedia of personal care. That's a very clear stated intent. If there is any question that a consumer has on personal care, it should be answered by one of our brands. And that's what we are working towards. You know, when we have a Lakme Fashion Week, during the classical days, a few hundred people would attend the Lakme Fashion Week. Then we would make TV program out of it. But today, when we run the Lakme Fashion Week and we set up the command center, a girl sitting in Gorakhpur can relate to Lakme Fashion Week as if she was sitting and watching the Lakme Fashion Week. She can engage with the brands with the same passion as a woman sitting and watching the fashion show. That's what, again, technology allows you to do. Now, content has to be delivered across delivery channels, different channels. Now, this is a great example of Lifebuoy. Now, this happened when we had the crisis of the South African team, yeah, when they were tampering with the ball. Now, within a few hours, Lifebuoy came out with an ad, rub your hands clean with this and not with the ball. Yeah. Now, that is contextual content. That is where you make a difference. A couple of years back, we had that classic one of Vim. This was when an e-commerce company, instead of delivering a smartphone, delivered a bar of Vim dishwash. The consumer raved and ranted on the social media. Before the e-commerce company could react, we had picked up a smartphone and delivered it to the consumer. Okay. Yeah. Now that is where content plays so, it plays such a big part. In HUL, we have created what we call as the U Studio. That's the Unilever Studio. So we don't have to go outside to create meaningful content. We have started creating it ourselves. Because today the time lag between when you need to put the content up for the consumers has become very small. It has become nanoseconds. If you don't react with speed, you'll miss the boat. Now, when we look at commerce, commerce is not just about selling a product. It is the entire experience that the consumer goes through. That is how it becomes very fulfilling. That is where you see that you get start to converting from intent to purchase. If you're just looking at a transactional then it is short-lived. Then you're not developing a relationship with your consumers. When you provide an experience, that is where the relationship gets strengthened with the consumer. This was an Axe example that we did. We launched an Axe ticket recently, and we did it with the movie ticket buyers on Paytm. And that was an amazing success, reaching out to lakhs of people in a very meaningful way. But it is not just about the transaction. You have to build on that relationship which you have done and follow it through if you have to convert him into a regular consumer. Now, this is what we did is, like I was talking about when we talk about connect, it is not just with a television or it is not just with your devices and giving the same kind of mobile television ad on the mobile. This was geotagging that whoever was within the vicinity of a Magnum freezer would get an ad to come and try out the Magnum ice cream. Yeah. Now, this will become a way of life. This is a way of personalizing it. This is the way of targeting it with precision. And, again, when we had this, the last 26th Jan, the big day for the big bazaar, and that was a time when for a certain brand of ours, we had looked at a living standard measure, and we had said, which is the locality where the chance of conversion is the maximum? We geotagged it, and in those markets, the running rate went up by about 70%. Because you have identified who precisely your target is, and then you are able to customize your approach to them rather than reaching out to all the population and then hoping that someone will succeed in buying your products. Community becomes so important, especially when you talk about purposeful brands. Yeah, when they start talking about your brands, when they start talking about conversing, that is where you're building brand loyalties. And today, what you're trying to do is build relationship with the consumers. What technology allows you to do is build relationships. When we talk about 160 million consumers whose profile we have, we are not just looking at the width of data, we are looking at the depth of data. Every day we are asking ourselves, how do we enrich and get more about the consumers so that we can help them in their journey in a far better manner? That's what we seek to do on a daily basis. Now, marketing in the new age is all about the right message at the right time, in the right place, to the right person. Yeah? Now, this is something which you may say was even there before marketing in a connected world advented on us. But I think the difference is today technology allows you to do. Earlier, this was just about a wishful thinking. That's the big change that has happened. Now, personalization clearly stems from a belief that each individual is distinct. Each one has his own quirks. Each one has his own distinct needs and desires. And if you can customize your message to him at the point when he's most receptive to read, that is when you would have the biggest impact on the consumer. While talking about the marketing in a connected world, there are some things which don't change. First is the art of storytelling. Yeah? Marketing is a lot of not just about functional needs, but it is about traversing the emotional space in the consumer's mind. That's what it does. And the best way to do it is in a way you can communicate the story to the consumers so that you not only tell him about your functional needs, but you tell him how in the emotional space you can occupy that space and make a meaningful difference to him. Now, if you look at some of the great ads of today, you will see branding done in a very subtle manner because you don't need to talk about it. Yeah, if we talk about, say, I'll pick up a few examples from my stable. If you pick up a brand like Brookbond, Brookbond is all about togetherness. Yeah, when Thomas Brook came out with the brand Brookbond more than 100 years ago, it was still founded on the essence of togetherness. Even 100 years later, it is all about swad apne pan ka. If you see the kind of communication we had, whether it was the Hindu-Muslim, whether it was the live-in relationship, whether it is the transgender band, this is all about that over a great cup of tea, you come together and break barriers. That's what about Brookbond advertising communication is about. Similarly, if you look at Dirt is Good of Surf Excel, you don't need to talk about what necessarily a Surf Excel does because consumers know it. But the message that you're trying to communicate to the mothers is, let your kid blossom. Let your kid go and play. If he doesn't get dirty, he won't grow up. But remember, there is Surf Excel to take care of the stains if he gets dirty. That's what Dirt is Good is all about. So the fundamentals remain very consistent, though the way of communicating has undergone a dramatic shift. The other big thing is the purpose. We certainly believe that the brands with purpose are able to impact the society in a meaningful manner, and very importantly, they're able to reduce the environmental footprint. Today, the consumers are getting increasingly conscious about where the brand comes from. Does it come from an ethical company? Does it have a purpose bigger than meeting the functional needs? And if it does that, the consumer is willing to pay you more money for that. We did a study to find out that brands with a purpose, are the consumers willing to pay more money for that? And the overwhelming evidence we got, the answer was yes. Of course, there is a difference between communicating that, yes, we want to pay for more for it and opening up your purse and paying for it. But the very idea that they're willing to pay more will sooner or later get converted into the real life where they'll be willing to pay more for those brands. Now, marketing, like I said, is undergoing a big shift. It is not just the marketing. It is the entire business in a connected world. Our philosophy of 5 C's, the center is still the consumer. Then comes the connect, the content, the commerce, and the community. Conventional marketing, mass marketing, will give way to mass customization or increasingly precision marketing. Brands with purpose grow faster, and companies with purpose are valued higher. Yeah? All right. Do I have a few minutes to take a few questions? Noor.
You want to ask a question?
Hi, Noor from Business World. I thank you, sir, for a great presentation, as always. I wanted to get a sense of, because of precision marketing and mass customization, this whole notion about 50% of the ad budget was wasted. How much are we now saying? Has that 50% gone down? Do we know where it's wasted?
No, no. We are nowhere close to talking about high degree of... Can you ask the entertainer to stop, please? Yeah, we are nowhere talking about, you know, it has taken us years to try to raise the efficiency and effectiveness of television spends. Even now, we keep learning. The good bit is that with new technology, it is also significantly impacting the efficiency of our television spends. As far as the digital space is concerned, oh, there is a long way to go before you can say that you are really getting the value for every dollar spent. This science is evolving at a very fast pace. But because I'm very confident that with more of data, we will be able to get much better learnings out of how we have been spending the money.
Thank you, sir. Anybody else? Lift your hands up and I will be there. Sir, okay, come.
I'm Shashi Sinha from Lakshmi Media.
Hi.
I'm Ms. Mehta. I met you sometimes back at Mumbai Airport. My question is, while digital is giving us lots of insight and lots of precision, etc., is it still delivering the numbers that marketer, a large marketer like you, and many large marketers in a large society, country like India, are looking at? And are these numbers or data insights which are coming, are they more symptomatic than comprehensive marketing tools?
You know, again, when people talk about that 100% of the spend should be moving to digital and all, this is again, I find the question very amusing, honestly. Hamare desh mein, 67% of the people still are in rural India. Yeah? In our country, still wall painting, hoardings are still very relevant. So talking about that you move 100% of the spends to digital and all, you are talking about an age where you would be seriously either not reaching those consumers or you're not interested in those consumers. I think the important bit first to ask yourself is, who are my consumers? Who are my target consumers? And what is the most efficient way in reaching them? We have brought in a lot of science behind it. We still believe that for our mega brands, even today, the most cost-effective reach, up to about 30-35%, is still television. It is only beyond that you supplement it with other mediums to improve the efficiency of your reach. There could be niche brands where you could be living with only digital. But a company like Hindustan Unilever, where we reach 95% of the households in the country with one or more of my brands, I can very safely tell you that television, print, hoardings, wall paintings will still remain relevant for many years to come. Though our incremental spends more are going into the new age marketing, but that does not mean that we are going to pull the plug on the other mediums. Our job is to reach the consumers in the most effective way. So that's what we are doing. But what we are bringing in, amazing science which was not available earlier, to non-digital, like television, like hoarding, we've now got a huge amount of science into where we need to place our hoarding. What height? How many days that hoarding should remain before it gets changed? So that's where we are bringing in the science.
All right, two more questions to go. Yes, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I'm an entrepreneur in the food and beverages space. So my question is specifically directed to that. In the context of a lot of e-commerce growth, even though it is only 4% out of the entire commerce that is happening, if we see a brand like Quality Walls, I mean, my question is that, sir, like, do you see a potential or an opportunity for a startup in the future where there is less of a physical presence for a product like a Quality Walls in terms of a physical retail store versus selling online? Do you see that happening, or is that a distinct possibility at all?
You know, where is the challenge today in e-commerce? The biggest challenge in e-commerce today is the last mile delivery. Yeah? Unlike, say, Airbnb or Book My Show, where you can go and get your ice cream or go and get your ticket at the movie hall or Make My Trip, where you don't need anything physical. Hamare dhande mein, aapko hum virtually to ice cream khila nahi sakte. Theek hai na? Aapko magnum deni padegi, taste karni padegi. So that's the critical difference. We can create models where the last mile cost is phenomenally high, yeah, then it will not be sustainable. It will be great for a presentation. I can come here and tell the audience, man, I don't need the thousands of freezers that I've placed all over India. Yeah, you can place it all and I'll have someone like Swiggy come and deliver it to you and all. But the cost will be so phenomenal, it will not make sense.
So because in the food service space, right now about 15 to 20% of the sale is online, and Swiggy is actually expecting it to be 40 to 50% in the next 3 years.
Yeah.
So in this context, would you see a potential where a brand is not having a physical store? Of course, the freezers will still be there, but it will not have a physical store in a mall, but it will be only pickup or this.
Again, it depends on your ambition. Agar aap baat karte hain ki 50-100 crore ka business hai, you can live with it. It's a niche. If you have a brand like ours, brands like ours, which are spread across the length and breadth of the country, you know, our intention is that we would like you to have Magnum at arm's reach of desire. Jab bhi man kiya, kha liya. And even if you're traveling somewhere, yeah, agar aap Vaishno Devi ja rahe hain, wahan bhi aapko Magnum milni chahiye, aap, you know, Kerala ja rahe hain, wahan bhi Magnum milni chahiye. In that case, I don't see where we don't have freezers. So we have to be very realistic about your ambition and then come to a conclusion whether is it feasible or not. If it's a very small brand, you can play around with it.
Thank you so much.
You know, he's got a brand called Thick Shake, which gives great milkshakes, sir. It's outside. You should try it out, sir. And you know what, ladies and gentlemen, he's so happy asking Mr. Mehta a question. He's announced just now, everybody here gets a free Thick Shake from him outside. Round of applause for him, ladies and gentlemen.
Not only that, for a month.
For a month. Taliya bajaiye this dildar ke liye. Thank you, brother.
And you won't have to go to his store. He will deliver it to you.
Sir, aisa na ho, next show mein bina kapde ke yahan pe aayega, sir. Brother, sit. God bless you. May you always have Thick Shake. I mean, sell Thick Shake. All right, anybody else? Last question for Mr. Mehta. Uske baad we're going to get the awards. Anybody else at the back? You look like a man who's had a lot of Thick Shake, sir. Khade hoiye, sir. Can I come to you there? All right. This lovely man, what a beautiful smile. You were smiling as if you just got married today.
Yes, sir.
Sir, it was quite enlightening to hear you. I've heard you earlier also. I wanted to ask you about retail business.
Yeah.
You see, for every business, consumer is always at the heart of the business. What about retail? If a retailer is not your consumer of your product, then, and also in the case when he's a part of your, he's a consumer also and a retailer also. How do you manage all that stuff? Because
We will love both the retailers. The one who is already my consumer or my customer, of course, we will deepen our relationship with them. But those who aren't storing HUL products, I would love to go and understand from them, ki yaar, aap kyun nahi karte ho? These are some of the best brands in the country. Yeah? Our products are available today in about 8 million stores across the country. So if there is a shop where our product is not available, you tell me, I will go and meet them.
It's not about he not keeping your products, HUL product, but he promoting competitors' product, keeping your product as well.
Acha. You know, first, I think we have to accept that business is not a zero-sum game. Agar usne aur koi company ka brand grow karta hai, that doesn't mean that I won't grow. In a country like India, there is a space for everyone to grow. From my brands to the milkshake guy. Everyone has immense opportunity to grow. Now, we have to remember something. There is something called a push and something called a pull. Why do many of the retailers by perforce store our brands? Because they know that there will be many consumers who will come and ask for Tresemme or Lakme or Lux or Lifebuoy or Taj Mahal or Surf Excel. Agar wo nahi rakhega, he will lose his throughput. Yeah. Now, when a retailer generally does a push when he gets a higher margin for it. So our story to a retailer is, ki I may not give you the highest margin on a product, but you need to look at the total throughput of HUL that goes through your store and the total money that you make on a brand. And then you should ask yourself, is it worthwhile to store our brands or not? A retailer is a very sensible man. He's a much smarter than you and me. And he knows that when he's going to make money, he'll store our brands. Yeah? Gentlemen?
So, ek aur kar lete, sir. You're okay for one more? All right, one more question. Sir, where? Sir, mane, 25th question of the day, sir. Quarter century mara in log taali bajaiye, sir.
Sanjay Banerjee. Digital advertising.tech. I have two questions. One is, you were saying that, consumers are prepared to pay a higher price when they understand about the environmental and the impact in the society. So this includes a rural area also?
See, this is what we did was more of an urban survey. And this we did it not just in India, across the world. And most of the places, the overwhelming evidence was that consumers today are increasingly interested in knowing the purpose behind the company and the brand. I'll give you another anecdotal evidence. When we, every year I go to many of the IIMs to talk to the potential students, to the students who are our potential employees. And the maximum number of questions that I get from them are on a sustainable living plan. Because today's generation is far more conscious about what we are doing to the planet, what is our purpose, what is our values, what are our ethics. They're very conscious about that.
My second question.
Arey, sir. ये इतने सारे questions तो sir पूरा 4 days चले जाएगा sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mr. Mehta, you were talking about IIMs. I have a humble request. I've been trying to get into the gate of IIM. They don't allow me, sir. How do I get in, sir? You tell me that. That is very important. I want to click a picture there and show to my mother.
देखो अभी तक उन्होंने आपका attire नहीं देखा है. जब देखेंगे इतने cool dude हैं आप, then they will let you in absolutely without any problem.
I love you, sir. मोजे के पैसे नहीं है sir, इसलिए. All right, Mr. Mehta, we've got a gift for you, which
you.
Mr. Ulf will give you. Please come in, ladies and gentlemen, for Mr. Ulf. And remember, we are taking a 40-minute break after this. Thank you. Hamari didi ke liye taali bajaiye. Badi sushil ladki hai. Thank you, Mr. Mehta.